Hello, hello, and good evening, everyone. Welcome to the third episode of the Italian Dojo. Today, focus on Marco Rodriguez. We have the music. Okay, I try to keep the music low. Okay. And okay, I hope the level is good like this. Okay, and we have the sensei. Sensei should be ready. Okay. Koro, hello.
Hi.
And welcome again. Thank you for being here once again.
Thank you to invite me.
Okay, so sensei voice is a bit low.
I will talk louder.
Okay, let me see. Oh, we have... Oh, Lobo Solitario, hello. Ciao, amico. Thank you for the follow. So, ciao caro. Well, let me just do small adjustments. In the beginning, I'd like to ask you if I remember correctly. Last time you told me that your first main was Rock Howard, and your second main was Marco, right?
Exactly.
Okay, nice.
I played Rock for 3 years. And then I stopped the game for 2 years, and when I come back, I think I started Marco pretty fast. Oh. And now I use Gato a lot more, but my best character is probably Marco.
Ah, okay, nice. Why did you pick? What did you make a choose? Did you, yeah? Why did you choose Marco as your main? I think you saw something in the character, since you played Rock 3 years, so you knew the game a lot more. And yes. Why did you choose Marco?
Because Rock is... I should not say that, but Rock, you can do anything except if you are good at the game, and I wasn't really that good at the game at this time.
Okay.
And Marco is a lot easier to use. He has huge damage, and his pressure is pretty high. Also, he's a really aggressive character, and that's my style. So I think Marco fits my style well better than Rock.
Ah, okay. I see. Nice. So let me just bring up, recall my Google Sheet for the program of the lesson. Here you are, and we can start. You can start. No, yeah, you can challenge me if you if you already changed the deep switches on 5K.
I have done it. Normally, it's okay. We can go.
Okay. Let me just. I'm offline. Okay.
Yeah.
The challenger. So we can start with the training mode. See?
No. Okay. Ah, we should have three. That's right.
Yeah. Okay. Nice.
Maybe we can start in a versus mode. No, I don't know.
In the versus, I think it's way better to start with the training mode.
Okay.
Yeah, so we can start at first. We have to see neutral attacks, neutral game, yeah. And the gauge charging method for butt.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, Bat. I have Bat. Say, I see Bat, but it's Marco Rodriguez, the original name.
We call it Marco, but is actually his English name. So.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. Okay, let me just boot a bit. Okay, the audio from Fightcade.
Maybe I'll change stage because this one hurt my eyes a lot.
Okay, yeah, yeah. This stage is a bit hard for the eyes. Okay.
The moving train is horrible.
Okay, nice.
So
we talk about neutral at first.
Yep. So Marco, as I say, is a really aggressive character, which has huge reward on all his normal moves.
Okay.
He's too big, he's into DP, he's 2A also, he's 5A also. Close D2 and the close C also leads to DP, so you have huge damage from all your buttons, which is really good in this game.
Okay.
To control space on the ground, one of your best moves will be 2B.
Okay.
Will stop, except against Janet and Griffin. But
okay.
Something else, but they stop ground approaches, so you can nearly spam it, and you can also confirm it on reaction.
Oh, nice!
It's pretty cool. Your 5A has a huge range, but in Garou, mostly all low move will low profile. His 5A.
Okay.
So if you net press 2B there, she will beat my 5A.
Okay, okay, I see.
But you can use it to cover some space. If she's dashing on you, you can just spam this move, mm-hmm. and she will be stopped. It's also a great move to stop jumps.
Okay.
Which is great. If she, maybe I can show it.
Yeah.
I should. Every time she tries to jump, I can stop it like this.
Okay. Well.
Which is pretty good because in Garou, the most common way to get out of the pressure is to jump. So it's a pretty good thing to have. I can like cancel his jump, then combo after it when she lands, or I can just put my guard.
Okay.
Everything which is. It's a classic in neutral. His close D is my favorite move of Marco. It leads to really huge damage, as you can see. It's like with a top, it's already 39 damage, which is huge in this game. It means that if I land this combo, the opponent loses his top attack, which is really great.
Okay.
His close C isn't that great, but he is a two-hit move,
yeah.
which can break some guard cancel. So you can use it in neutral. You can also buffer a throw doing this. If I'm doing it while I'm walking forward, it will throw. And if I'm not at the good range, it will land this move, which will break a must guard cancel.
Okay, nice.
So it's pretty good. You can also fend it if you're dead. And after the fend, you still get a huge reward.
Ah, okay.
See?
Nice.
Yeah,
yeah. You can combo a lot of neutrals with the specials.
Yes. And you can combo nearly. The main goal of Marco is to land the DP. And he can do it after every move, which is really great.
Oh. Okay.
His far D is not that great, but you can. It's a Marco specific stuff. Mm-hmm. If you press D then C at the far range, you can cancel the far D like this.
Oh, nice.
Which gives you a little momentum. It's not that great, but it's good to know. But I nearly never use it because I don't really see the utility. Maybe someone will find it, but I don't.
Okay.
What can I say? Fardy, like I said, isn't really good. Farsi also is not that great, but it has a huge range, so you can control some space with it.
Okay.
But you have no reward after it, and I'm pretty sure it's unsafe. I look at the data, at the frame data a little later, but I'm pretty sure that reversal zero frame will beat it. So use it with caution. He also has a good jump. He has every jump move or good air move or great with Marco. His jump D is one of the best jump D in the game. I would say it's the fourth best jump D in the game.
Okay.
So you can use it to pressure really well. He also have a really good jump D, which is active on really long time, so you can cross up and beat most of stuff using this move.
Okay.
His jump A is here to win air-to-air situation. He has a huge range, and it will beat most of the air trade. So you can use it well. He also has the target combo in the air, which is great. It breaks GD tries. If they don't know how to deal with the target combo, you can just use it.
Okay.
Like this.
Oh,
once
nice.
You know how to GD a target combo, it's not as useful, but most people don't know how to do it, so it's okay.
Yeah.
And his jump C is a little slow, but that's what makes it great. If you try to guard cancel, for example, this move or this one, and I do this one, you will get baited by the timing. So it's a good mixer.
Oh, nice.
Also
okay.
I'll show it maybe later, but you also have some setup with it. When I do this, depending on the time I press C, it's cross up or not.
Okay.
So it's really hard to deal with.
So it's a cross up even. Okay.
It's a cross up even if it's
front.
In front. Yeah.
Okay. I was talking with. Sorry. Yeah, yeah, what are you saying?
Maybe not against you, but I should be able to go in the back also.
Yeah, I was talking with Kusanagi a few days ago, because he used to attack me on wake up with a jump attack, and I couldn't block. And he told me that it was a cross-up, and it was a cross-up even if he hit in front of me.
Yep, it's a really common thing in this game, especially with top-tier characters like Janet. Janet Jump D, for example, will cross up while landing in front.
Okay.
All the time, it's horrible. It's Garou specific. It's not every character can do this, probably. I don't know all the characters very well, but
okay.
I think I deal with it against every character or nearly every character in this game.
I see.
And maybe people don't know. So it's not specific to Marco. It's an overall mechanic. But when you land the throw, there's a bug where your next move, even though it lands in front, can cross up.
Okay. So the best
like
way to get
it,
out is to
if I do it, to cross up.
Okay.
But if I do this, it's in front. So it's a 50-50 mix-up after a throw. And it doesn't work only in the corner. It also works here. It's harder to do because I need to go fast. But you can do this in every situation with every character.
Okay.
You just need to know which button will cross up or not. And you can do it in training mode to see. It's not that hard to understand.
Okay.
You can also, for example, If Janet do this, she can cross up with her dive while hitting in front. Which is pretty horrible to block.
Okay.
So, it's the Garou specific thing. This game is broken, so...
Okay.
It's hard to say if it's a bug or not, but there it's clearly a bug.
Okay. Did you talk about the six...
I was going to.
Oh,
he has,
okay, okay.
His overhead.
Yeah.
His overhead is really, really good. It's one of the best in this game. It's a command move, 6A, which can combo into anything.
Wow.
Maybe not this one. No. I'm missing my input.
Yeah, okay. This is
a big input. But, yeah. The Hidden or the normal one also.
Yeah.
This wow. one will work the same way. You can also link some normal move after that.
Yeah. Okay.
In the corner, you can go for close D. But mid-screen, for example, if you land it a little far, you can do this kind of stuff. Which is pretty optimal at this range. Need to have the good range, but it still does a lot of damage. And the thing is, it's pretty unreactable. I think, if I don't say bullshit, it's something like 8 frame?
Okay.
8 frame of startup? Sorry. I'll just check because I'm not sure. Frame data. So, yes, yeah, 6. Oh no, it's a 15 frame startup. I was wrong, but
okay.
And I consider that something under 18 frames is unreactable.
Okay.
For a human, for sure. It's really hard to deal with. Also, you can't really deal with because he has the same reward on the 2B. So you are always mixed between high and low against Sparko, which is hard to deal with.
Okay.
And it's one of the reasons he's the top tier, I think.
Yeah.
He has a really good pressure overall.
Yeah,
he's
well, anyway,
really
it's...
offensive, and he can kill you in two openings. I think that if I use it too high...
Yeah.
It's this.
yeah, nice. I hate a lot of this playing against the Marco players. Yeah, anyway, that overhead is really hard to react because if you're expecting it, you can do something. You can just block.
You can block, or you can even press a button. Most of the button are 3 frame. Enfin, most of light attacks are 3 or 4 frame.
Yeah.
I believe in this game, so you can try to intercept it. But most of the time, you will get hit if you use it well. So it's really hard to deal with this move.
Yeah,
but it's doable.
Especially because he can mix up with the low attacks, mm-hmm. and I find his low attacks very very fast, like the fastest in the game. Yeah, I don't know.
I'm not sure it's the fastest, but it's quite fast. I think he's 2B have a 4-frame startup.
Okay.
Let me check. Yes, 4-frame startup, which is one of the fastest in the game. But most of the 2B in this game are 4-frame or 5-frame. So I'll say it's okay. It's not the best 2B in the game, but it's a really good one.
Okay.
Same for his close and far A. They are 4-frame. Which isn't the best, because some characters have 3 frame 5A, which is a good tool to have in this game. Marco has 4. Well, it's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure anyway that Marco don't really, in my opinion, maybe some other Marco player won't be agree, but I'm pretty sure neutral is not what you're going for with Marco.
Okay.
You're here to be offensive and open your opponent with a move that leads into DP. That's your main goal as Marco. Because once you do that, if you do that 2 times with meter, it's one. Zen 6.
Yeah.
Game over. And that's why I think Marco is one of the most frustrating characters to face, because he can kill you really fast with two poor mix-up, and okay, it's really hard to deal with. So I think it's one of the characters you need the most time to understand well.
Okay.
I think.
Okay, nice. Kuza, hello, welcome, and thank you for the host. So the overhead, there's the overhead with A plus B.
Yep, which is not that good. To be honest, you don't use it. I mean, this one is way better, faster, and has a huge reward. This one, if you kill with it, you can try, but I don't see the point using this one.
Okay.
But his 2AB is quite good, and like all other moves, or nearly all other moves, you get a huge reward for it.
Oh,
so,
nice.
And it's a nice anti-air also, so you can use it, and I recommend using it in some matchup, like against Jeannette, if you get it. Let's try this. It should work. You can do stuff like this and follow up. It's really rewarding.
Okay.
Stuff like this.
Okay.
It's specific to Jeannette, but I can just go for T and do the same stuff. So I love this move. I found it really good. You can also fend it if you hit. So there's no reason not using it.
Yeah.
And I think this one is, let me check, but if I think this one is safe on block, which is not the case for every 2AB in this game. But this one I think is safe. Oh no. Oh, see, yes, it's safe. It's 0-1 block, so it's safe.
Ah, it's 0 on block?
Yep. 0 on block. And minus 6 on hit, but since you can cancel it on hit, there's no reason to get punished for it.
Oh, nice.
So okay. It's okay. It's a really good move to use. 9 frame okay. Startup, and he's active for 3 frames, which is great. You should use it.
Okay.
But, like every 2AB, you should be careful because you can... well, there's not much risk to use it, but it's not that free to use correctly. So you need to train the space and which move you can beat with it. Which sometimes it's hard to tell. For example, Jeannette, you can 2AB Jeannette jump D, which is quite strange because you should be invincible from high attack.
Okay.
But again, some move you can't. So you need to know which move you can deal with.
Okay, I see. Hello, Squall. Welcome. Nice, yeah, a lot of damage.
Yes, this character is stupid. Not gonna lie, everything is stupid, and that's why I love you.
I see. What about his top move?
His top attack, you can use it in combo, but I don't see the point using it. So it's that.
Okay.
Which is okay on combo, but. I'd say that every move does the job as well as it, so I don't know why you should use it.
Okay.
You see, and the bad part about it, in the corner it's pretty good to use, even though you have better conversion, but it's quite okay, because the last hit will whiff, and you can juggle with something else.
Yeah.
let me try again with DPC. Pussy. Ouais, yes. You need to do DPA, so it's not that good, in fact. But you can do something like that.
Check with DP break with the ADP.
Yes. Oh, wow. But this one will do the same stuff. Okay. And is I recommend using this combo instead of the top move. But if you find this one easier, maybe go for this one. It does a little less damage. So this one is the classic corner combo.
Okay, yeah, because DP break with the ADP is pretty hard.
There's a trick to get better at guard canceling DP with every character. Yeah. You need to hold the diagonal direction when you, when you do a DP in this sense, the motion in 6 to 3.
Yeah.
And you need to hold 3. You need to hold 3 or the game, if let's say you hold 6 when you finish your DP.
Yeah, okay.
The game will, with when you press the break for AB,
yeah,
the game will understand that you try to do this and won't
okay.
break. So you really need to hold the 3.
Okay, so the game
and
understands
the
that...
The break will be way easier.
Yeah,
it's,
okay.
To be honest, it's quite easy when you know the trick of holding 3 or 1 in the other direction. But once you know it, it's quite easy.
Okay. It's,
I don't know the... I mean, I'm not the execution god, huh? So if I can do it, trust me, everyone can. Really.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's it for his normal move.
Yeah.
And his top attack.
Yeah. We have the Gorge charging method. Does he have any way of charging?
There's two ways of charging. You can land Fireball. This something people must understand is that his fireball are really, really strong. It's the best fireball in the game by far.
Yeah.
And it has two purposes. So the first one is to charge, is to gain some meter and to apply a sort of neutral, I would say. Long range fireball. So in this game, since you can GD and get back a little health, it's like doing fireball at this range is like getting meter against giving health to your opponent. So I would say it's okay to do this kind of trade.
Okay.
Because meter is quite important with Marco, since he super does so much damage.
Mm-hmm.
You can also, on every knockdown, you can use your counter. So
okay.
You can use your counter to move forward and gain a little meter. That's his best way to gain meter. You can also DP break in Wii, which is way harder because the timing is hard. But you can also do this. If you're confident with it, you can.
Okay.
But,
nice.
But I would say that Fireball and Counter is the way to go to gain some meter easily. That's the best way for me to gain meter. Because if the bad thing about DP breaks, if you miss it, you're really free on the landing.
Yeah.
And you will miss it most of the time. Even after hours of training, it's not one of the DP. It's the hardest break in the game, I would say. So it's hard to do it when you whiff. And even after playing game for hours, I miss it a lot.
Okay.
So I would say the Fireball, Counter, it's the way to go.
Okay, nice.
And it I think... Also something that maybe... people don't know, In this game, the more you deal damage, the more meter you gain.
Okay.
So when you are in top, you gain more meter by doing your special move.
Okay.
So if you really want to gain meter, try to do it when you are in top attack. You will gain way more meter. Maybe it's hard to see with your eyes, but I would say, let's try, that you have to do maybe one or two less special in top to gain 1 meter complete, which is not that bad.
Okay.
Up. And...
Yeah, no, you have to use the super. Okay.
So, in this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Okay.
And in top, it should be, I would say, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Wait, yes, 9.
Yeah, a couple less. Yeah.
Yes, it's a couple less. It's pretty important because on some matchup, I mean, with Marco, you want to put your top bar in first.
Yeah.
But in some hard matchup, like Jennet, you can try to put it in another part of your health to gain meter at a delayed moment. I don't know if I'm really clear with it, but I would recommend anyway to put your top in first place with Marco.
Yeah, with Marco is way better.
Because you deal so much damage without meters that you went to be explosive at start.
Yeah, I think the same. Marco is that kind of character that I have no doubts on where to put, when to place the top.
Yes.
While, for example, with my main, with Dong, I tried different spots, the first, the second, the third, and usually I find myself way better with the last third of health.
Okay.
But yes. Because of my playstyle. But with Marco, even if I am not so aggressive, just like using fireballs at the beginning of the match while the other player have to reach me, gives me a lot of meter right at the start. So it's way better.
Oh, also, I didn't say it, but Marco's fireball damage depends on how far you do it. So there, it will do 18.
Okay.
But there, it will do 30.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Which is great. And it also not done at close range. Let me turn this off. It's not done and gives more damage. I think that against character like Griffin or Grant, this fireball at close range deals more damage than Rock Super.
Okay.
So it's a really, really good move.
Yeah, it deals a lot of damage. So nice.
Yes.
Since you started talking about specials, we can go on and talk about specials.
Okay. So, as I said earlier, the main goal with Marco is to land a DT break. So, first of all, if you want to play Marco efficiently, I would recommend to train his break because it's his main tool. His DP... his DPA. Let's start with the AD. It starts in 3 frame, which is his fastest move except super.
Okay.
And he is plus 2. Yes.
Okay.
He's plus 2 on block, which means he's safe. You can spam it. The bad part about it is that you stay on your you don't go forward. You stay where you are when you do it.
Yeah.
The DPC has also a 3 frame starter, but he's 0 on block. So it's a 50-50 situation after it.
Okay.
On block. And the good part is that you go a little forward, which is good mid-screen. And there's a bug with Marco DP. I don't know if it's a bug or a hitbox problem, but if you land his DP too far, you want put your opponent in a juggle state. You like I will find the range like there.
Okay.
See,
yeah.
It doesn't go in the sky. So you're unsafe when you do this. It's hard to have this range, but you're unsafe when you do this. And if you do it in some combo, like this should not launch, you don't have the fireball follow-up, which is really good to deal damage.
Nice, yeah.
So in combo, I will recommend using, in mid-screen, I will recommend using the C version, because since you go a little more forward, you will launch most of the time.
Okay.
And on block, I will recommend using the A version, which puts you in a safe spot, and nothing can happen to you if you put your guard after it.
Yeah, right. Okay. Yeah, because it's plus two.
It's plus two, and you don't move. So even if I miss the break, it's hard to punish. See, there, Jeannette, the only way she has to punish is to read that I miss the break, then dash forward. Not that easy to do in a real situation.
Okay, I see. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I recommend using it when you hit the block state. You just go for the ADP, and on hit you go for the CDP. That's it.
Okay.
That's the main tool of Marco. I love to see it as a jab with armor, because you can guard cancel it. So I can just go forward and try to guard cancel. And if I hit the guard cancel, it means that I have a free combo. And if I hit the block, I'm safe. So I see it as a light with armor.
Okay, okay, okay.
That's my way to think about it. So sometimes, most of the time, you don't do this, but sometimes you can just go forward and try to do a guard cancel, and you'll see what happens. Most of the time, only good things will happen, and it's a good way to use it also.
Okay.
Then after this DP break, he has his fireball. His fireball, the A is a little slow, and the C version is a missile. At this range, it's pretty unwreckable. It goes really fast and huge, and deal a huge
damage.
Not damage.
The guard break.
Yeah, yes, the guard break. It's good to put pressure with it.
Yeah.
Also, she can jump, but it's a fireball mind game. So if she saw it coming, she can just jump and punish. But against Marco, you don't really want to jump.
Okay.
So you can use it this way. And he has his counter. The A version of the counter I move. So jump. Yes, but I can put her on us. Yes, I can. Oh, well, we'll show it later, maybe, because it will be hard to show that. So this one is high, and the B version is a low counter, which is a little faster, but it's harder to use because it's hard to see a low move coming, most low move are fast, so it's more of a mind game than a reaction.
Okay, yeah.
I think I never use it for the counter part. I use it just for the mobility.
Okay.
Because it's fast and it gives you a little meter, so it's okay.
Okay. Is the recovery is the same for the high version and the low version?
Let me check, but I would say that I put I can say is a frame data to Zen Khalid, but I think you recover faster with the B version.
I think. Yeah, because you said that the low one is faster.
Yes.
So maybe it's better to move with the low one.
But it may be just an impression, I won't lie. Maybe it's just an impression. Let me check the startup. It's 3 frame startup for boss, so maybe it's just an impression.
Okay.
But on most setup and most... when I watch Tamura, which is the best Marco player in the world, mm-hmm. when I watch him for setup or after a knockdown, he always uses the boss version. So I do the same.
Okay, yeah.
Maybe it's just a preference. I can say, to be honest. But he has also. I think I cover all of these pieces.
No, there are the two moves: the quarter circle forward.
Oh yes, the Tatsumaki. I forget always. So you have this Tatsumaki, which is a good tool in combo for two reasons. Because first of all, it does a little less damage than Fireball. So as you can see, Fireball, this combo does 47, which is huge. And this one will do 39, but you get more space. You put the opponent in the corner way faster with this one. So you can use it. You can use it to put your opponent in the corner fast. But you lose a little damage. So it's depending on the matchup. Some matchup you went to put your opponent in the corner, so you will do this one. And in some matchup you don't really care about the corner situation, so you go for the fireball.
Okay.
It's really depending on the matchup. So I will say, for example, that Tzok, which has a really good neutral game, you want to put him in the corner. So I will recommend using this one. But against Jeannette, for example, the only reason you want to use it, it's in this situation. If you are in the corner, you don't want to be there, so you go for it.
Okay.
Gain a little space and get out of the corner, which is the worst situation in the game. It's being against Jeannette in the corner. It's mostly death if you get in the corner against this character.
Okay.
And the D1, yeah. He has a strange property, but this one isn't that great like this. But if you do it after a guard cancel, it will put the opponent in the hard knockdown, so she can't roll, she can't do anything on the ground. But it only work after a guard cancel, and sadly, it's not the best guard cancel that Marco has. So in some situation, it's good, but most of the time, that's not what you are going to do.
Okay, nice.
And I use it sometimes in combos. I don't really know why, but sometimes I use it. It still does a little more damage than the B version.
Yeah.
I think it will do like 2 more damage. Yes, 2 more damage, but you put the opponent a little less far away, so not that great.
Okay.
Just something I have to say to people who wants to play Marco.
Yeah.
Marco really needs guard cancel. The thing you need to train first is break. The second thing you need to train is guard canceling. In fact, I think that all his defensive tools are good only if you can guard cancel with them.
Okay.
So it's not that hard, to be honest. It's a little tricky because you need to know how to guard cancel with a DP, but I will tell you.
Yeah.
So, a DP motion, let's say in this sense, it will be easier, is 6-2-3. I will use number notation. I found it easier, but I don't know if everyone knows it. It's 6-3, but you can go, if you want to get cancel, you can do something like 6-5-4-2-3 or 1-2-3.
Yeah.
And you will do a guard cancel DP if someone hits, and if there's no hits, the DP will still come out. It's a good way to guard cancel with DP. It's quite easy. It's like super in most anime game. I think even in KOF, there's some super with this kind of motion. It's not that hard. You just need to think about it when you do it. The hard part when you do this is to stay on three to break the DP. Because since you will do you will do six, then a half circle forward, you still need to hold the diagonal to get the easy break. And it's the hard part.
Okay.
And it's one of the tricks you need to know with Marco, because everything of what Marco does will start most of the time from a guard cancel, and it's I would say it's his strength and his weakness also, because if you can't guard cancel, you won't do anything with this character, because you don't have the defensive tool he should have. So really train on your guard cancel. Even if you can guard cancel with your DP, don't forget that guard cancel fireball still does a really good amount of damage and put a knockdown. So it's okay, even though you will prefer to do this, because after a guard cancel DP, you can put a super, for example, or something like that. You will get a better reward with DP. Also, and that's the tricky part, because even though Marco is an easy character, there's many air moves that when you guard cancel, you need to know if you have to break your DP or not. Like, we'll show it later, but for example, you can guard cancel DP break grand jump D because it will whiff. So you have to do something else, like fireball or DP that you don't break, because otherwise you will just do this. It will just DP break in whiff, and you're in the bad spot after that. So you need to know which move you can deal with which card guard cancel. That's the hard part about Marco, I would say.
Okay. Another thing that Marco has as his specials are the charge, the punch and kick.
Yes, but I will be honest with everyone.
Yep.
Those moves are trash and you never use them. Like, never. There's one trick I can show you.
Yep.
But I need to go back to the menu. You can start holding the buttons from the character select screen. So you can have...
You can start holding the button?
Yeah, I can. If I start holding there, it counts as when the match starts. So, we'll show you, but that's the only way to use it efficiently. And I miss it. I release it too fast. But those moves are trash. Don't use them. The bad part about it is that if you hold the D button, you can't use your D, which is your best normal move.
Yeah.
If you hold the C button, you can fireball C, which is your one of the best special moves.
Okay.
And you get nothing from it. It's really unsafe. It's not that fast. I think that if you went to use it, it's that you are trolling someone weaker than you. That's all. That's the only reason you went to use it. And you can charge it a really, really long time. Maybe there. No, it wasn't long enough. See, I think I started to charge it at 17 and at 7 it wasn't fully charged. So really don't use this mode.
Needs a lot of lot of time.
Yes. To be honest, I never saw them in real matches, and at a point that I forget them. To be honest.
Okay.
You don't want to use those moves. Maybe in a combo video you can get a trade and then a follow up, but in real matches, no use for them. Okay. Really, no use for them.
Okay, okay, fine. Let me see, we can go back to the practice.
Yep.
And we have supers. We saw already some hit confirms and some combos conversions.
Yes, because Marco has a trick stuff. KO! He can combo fireball from light, but it's not just a cancel, it's what we call I don't know, wait, I'll do this, it's faster. It's what we call a Kara cancel. So Kara cancelling is the fact that you can cancel the startup of a move by a special of a normal move by a special move.
Okay.
And Marco light attacks aren't cancelable. You can cancel them. But you can, how can I say it in English? You can spam lights if you want. So you will do light fireball cancel if you want.
Okay.
I'll show you. It will be easier. But to be honest, it's hard to see. So you won't probably get it. But there, if I do 5A fireball, it will do this, which won't combo because my light can be canceled. But I can do this kind of stuff, so it's hard to do just with one, but and it's hard to do, just hard to do, to be honest. It's not that hard once you get the timing done. As you can see, you can still combo it, and to do it, we'll use what we call a P-Link, maybe a P-Link. Maybe people don't know what it is.
You mean the piano input?
It's just pressing the button say then A with a little delay.
Yeah.
You see, you don't press them together, but there's just a little delay, and you do this after your fave A. You do a fireball. Pressing say then A quite fast.
Okay.
And it will do a Kara cancel. And then the fireball. It's quite hard to explain because I don't really. As I say, you can spam jab, but I can go for a special right after. But you can Kara cancel to do it. You can also do it with two. I can do it personally. It's way harder to do than with the fail A. And it only deals one more damage, so I'm pretty sure it's quite... Well, if you want to train it, you can, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't change anything to do it. Personally, I never... I can do it. I don't understand the timing. Some people tell me that it's easier, blah blah blah. I never saw it in a real match, so...
Okay.
I don't know. This one is... more easy and will do like one less damage, so I'm okay with it personally. It's easier and deals the same amount of damage, so okay. I won't bother training the hard version, which is not that better. Also, you can do this. How can I say? You can normally do this. This won't combo, but with the same trick, you can combo. You can Kara cancel a light punch into the super. tout combo. It's a little harder, but it's not that hard. Well, it's not that hard, but as you can see, I still miss it. I'm not really used to it because I don't find this combo really useful. You have better conversion, but to you can do it. I will.
You must crouch for 2B, Kara 2 wall.
You will do 2B, 5A, and then Kara A into Super C. The thing is that you have a 6A overhead, so your timing is quite hard. Yes, I will do it. You can do it. I personally think that this combo is just to show off you can do it. Okay. And it has no real use. Because for most ranges, if you land the 2B, you will go for a DP most of the time. And you will get the... I spam a little too much. But you will get the same reward with the DP. So I think it's better. But at this range... See, the 5A don't connect.
Yeah.
So there's no reason to use this combo. It also... This combo is hard because you have to press AD. The command for the combo is 2B. In this sense, we'll see later. It's 2B, 2, 3, 6, 5, AD. Then 2, 3, 6, say A fast as a penning. So it's hard. It's hard to do. Reward isn't that great, to be honest. And if you miss it, you lose your P power for nothing. So I recommend using it just to show off, maybe. But in a real match, most of the time you went to this. That's the way to go. But you can there this combo, which is quite hard, I found. Not that hard, but as you can see, I'm not used to it, so I miss it a lot.
Yeah.
But to be honest, I'm not sure. And that's happened if I miss the penning. The A super comes out, it doesn't combo, and I'm free. So I don't recommend people using this combo. It's hard for nothing, in my opinion.
Okay.
So, the basic conversion of Marco, because all his combo looks the same, to be honest, it will be to do a normal, because, as I say, you can cancel light attacks by special move, but the DP is so fast that you can link it. As you can see, I didn't do anything special. I just wait my 2B to be finished, and I land my DP. It's quite easy to do. Once you know how to DP web, I'd say. It's the same with A version.
Yeah.
Every combo will look the same, as I say. You will just do a normal move followed by a DP, then your fireball, or the Tatsumaki, or the super. Or boss in the corner.
Okay.
That's it. That's everything you will use. And I think in the corner, there's one specific trick to know is that if you want to do the biggest combo, you want to do it with DPA. Because if you don't do it with... See, that is the most damaging combo, I would say. But if you do it with DPC, you can do this. Like, the execution is on point tonight, again. Really on point. I can do this. See, it touched the ground and there's no follow-up. So you need to know how to do it with DPA. That's the only thing you really need to know with Marco in the corner. You can also, as I say, do this after the command overhead, which is great, and will deal a huge amount of damage. You can also go for the super, which deals 50% health. Yeah, stupid. You can jump, but it's just doing DP break into fireball. Once you know how to do it, you can do mostly every combo of Marco. Okay. But there's two things Marco has, and I don't really see people except me using. Enfin, except me and Tamura, because I learn everything. So. But. I don't remember which one. Wait, this is one. This. You can do this stuff. And this stuff will do something like 19% of crush bar. So, you, if no is full crush bar, if I do something like this, if I don't miss it, and I miss it, if I do this, just close D, break, then 5A, 5A, Aiden super, it will crush and it still does quite a lot of damage. You can also chip damage with it, because each move does one of the chip damage.
Yeah.
And as you can see, the end will crush. But if it is full bar and I go for the crush directly, I will crush at the end. And it should not work like this. So I don't understand why it does. But normally, you will crush at the end when the Shoryuken... Yes, but it's a training bug. Character can block zero frame. I don't know why, but that's how it goes. Maybe like this.
Okay.
So there, normally. Okay, I don't understand why that should not work like this. But so I guard cancel on the last hit on the DP, the last part is the DP.
Yeah.
But it doesn't hit. It crush, but it doesn't hit, so it's punishable for the opponent.
Ah, okay.
So you always want to do something before doing the crush combo. Because okay. If you don't, you will get punished for it.
Okay. So maybe it's another training bug
I think it's maybe because the character gets back up for no reason. I think that should be the reason. There's something also you need to know with this Aiden Super. His Aiden Super has 4 levels. And you only want to use the 3rd and the 4th version of it. So the 3rd version will be this one.
Okay.
And the 4th version will be the startup with Fireball. You will use the startup with Fireball, enfin the level 4 as I say, for combo. Because you can combo it after a DP break, which is a little hard, I'll show you, but the thing is, you have to delay a little. There, I did it too slow, and you see the last part doesn't connect. So you have to delay a little. It should work there. Yes. And as you can see, it does a lot of damage without top attack. And this one, when you went to crush or combo from lights. Okay. That's the only specific stuff you want to know with those moves. And I think we cover most of the stuff. There's combo like this, you can, because I don't use them often because they aren't that useful. Because if I land the close D, I can go for a DP than a fireball, which is better. But you can do something like close D, Fent, 5A, Fireball, which is not that easy because there's the Fent and the Kara cancel in the combo. But you can do this. It's not really useful, but in some situation, it's not that bad, okay. I would say. But most of the time, you go for DP anyway, which is better in most situations. Also, he has something that people maybe don't. I need to make it jump. If you land a non-break DPA on an air opponent like this, you can follow up with your super.
Oh. Okay.
Which is cool because it's easy to bait this jump with this DP. I will show you when we are versus because I will talk about an option select that is quite easy to use.
Okay.
And okay, you can also, which is harder because you have to land your DP when your opponent is really high. But you can go for this version too.
Oh, nice.
But it's way harder to do because you really need to hit when he's really high in the sky.
Okay.
But you can do this. And also, I think we can talk about his counter combo because he has some good counter combo. And don't forget that in Garou, you can counter with normal move. So this doesn't exist in a real match.
Okay.
You can counter with this move, you can counter with this one. Every normal move can counter. You can only counter with 2 AB, 2 AB, and your special move. And super odds.
Okay.
So the basic mid-screen counter combo will be DP break into DP break with a fireball. That's the basic. You have to wait a little or you won't land, you won't be able to break the second DP. So you'll do something like this with a little delay between each DP, which is not that hard. You also, in the corner, you have a better version of it. You can go for DP break, into DP non-break, then super.
Nice.
Which is the easy version. There's the version with a little more damage, but it's harder because you can go for the Tatsumakibi. But landing the 2 hit of the Tatsumakibi, it's not that easy. But you win most of the time with 1 hit, and you have nothing after it. So I recommend, if you're not really sure of what, just landing the DPA version after the double DP break. It's quite good, and I think it does something like 3 less damage. Not that important.
Okay.
And also a great variation, if you can put a DP counter, but you miss the break, and I think it's only with A version. I will try with fire and fireball. Like, if I do this, if I land this super on the frame, if I land this super when Terry touches the ground, it will block his input, so he can't move, and the super is guaranteed. It's a true combo that really exists. Because I don't know, Pip, I don't know if you know, but in this state, there you can roll normally, so you can avoid combo. But the super freeze blocks the rolls, and you can't move.
Ah, okay, so I see.
That's how it works with the most super in the game. I think Dong can do this. The only character that it doesn't work with is Terry for some reason. I can say why, but it doesn't work with Terry for a reason I can't understand.
Okay.
But most character can do this. And also you can do it after a fireball. And as you will see, you can do it for... you need to do this, you need to put your opponent in the launch state. But I think you can do it after DPC. I will try, but I think it was too late. We will try together after. But I think it doesn't work with DPC at this way.
Okay.
So that's most of it. If you... It will be a little hard to do, but I... Let's try from there. I can do it from this distance if I get a fireball counter anti-air. I'm pretty sure I can. it's quite hard, but I think I can. Because I need to land the super on the exact frame where it hits the ground. That's the thing.
Ah, okay, okay.
It doesn't work if I don't. So you can do it from max distance. But it's not that easy from far away.
Yeah.
But it's possible. And I think you also can do something like that at this distance. You can dash then TP. At this distance, it should work. Or maybe a little closer. It works. And then you have the juggle.
Ah, okay, okay.
You can follow up like this. It's a little hard, but depending on the range, it's not that hard.
Okay.
And you also have some conversion after counter, but I can't show it against the bot.
Yeah, sure. Maybe? We have to try yeah. In a versus mode. So this character does he use fan cancels at all, or?
You can use fan cancel. I would say that it's required at higher level, but against a mid-level player, you won't see there's no point using it. Okay, now I tell this. Let's say that.
Sorry. Go.
I need to find. I don't remember where the GD is, but if your opponent is able to guard cancel after a 2, like if I do this and my opponent can guard cancel it,
yeah,
I have to do this to break his double hit timing or I get punished. So that's the only reason you want to fight with Marco. You see that? With most characters, it's an infinite, but with Marco, it doesn't exist. There's a gap between each party. So there's no point. You can also fight after this move, because after a fight, let me show you. I need to toggle counter off there. If I do this, it won't combo with DPC, and it won't launch with DPA.
Okay.
So there's no point doing this, but after this one, you can still combo after doing the feint. So you can do it, but it's not that useful, to be honest. There's also a combo. There's plenty of little combo I don't show because I don't really see the point of them, but you can do something like that.
Okay, I see.
I think I never really saw it in a real match. You can also cancel a heavy for a sweep, which I found not that good. Because if I land a plus D, I want to break after it, not to put a sweep. So, not really useful, I would say. But that's it. There's a little. You can do stuff like this also, but it's hard for no reason. I think you don't. This version is way easier and will do like 3 less damage. So I recommend using maybe this one. And I don't press the button fast enough there, but you can also do the level 4, which is. We don't really care about it. And yes, I didn't say all the hidden super works. Maybe I should. So the hidden super is a 3 QCF forward with a 6 ton.
Yeah.
And during the freeze, you have to spam the C button fast. I say it's 7 for the. At least 7 for the level 3, and at least 11 for the level 4.
Ah, okay.
So maybe I will go a little closer to my stick, but you will hear me spamming like a stupid.
Okay.
I will need to spam it, because if you don't go fast enough, you will have this version, and in this situation, it does this, which is bad. And trust me, it's really tiring for the arm. You won't do this really often because you... Yeah. Well, I press start by mistake, but you see okay. What I say. It's hard to go fast, and do it often is really stressful for the... And that's it, I think I got most of this, I would say. Hein. Okay. After the overhead, you do this. In the corner, you can do that, but it's pretty much the same comp with an another normal pivot. Like, if you know how to do this, you probably know how to do this. And it's nearly the same combo, in fact, you just change the normal. That's it.
Okay, so for the training routines, you have just to train this, or like rock, it is better to train in movement instead
I
of...
I think it's better to train in movement,
okay.
But with Marco, it's not as hard as rock, because if you do it from a light, how can I say this? It's I always recommend to train while you're moving anyway. That's the best way to be able to do it in a real match.
Okay.
Because anyway, you will move at some point doing it. So there's no reason to train in from a standing position.
Yeah.
But it's easier to do that rock confirm, I would say, anyway. Oh, I forget something. You have combo, and I don't really know how it works, but you can do stuff like this against a jumping opponent, which should... I need to get it a little lower... But you can combo the fireball after you hit in the air. From a 5A, which is good because you can cancel jump, startup jump with 5A, and you can combo in fireball.
Ah,
but
okay.
It's hard to do because the opponent need to be quite low, and you can also do it with the DP version, with the DP, I mean. But I don't really understand how it works against Genet. You see, it works, but I don't know why. There, it won't again.
Ah, okay. It's not consistent, this one.
Yes, I don't really understand how it works. So maybe it's because I'm not fast, or because the character is too high, but you can do this. With the fireball, it's more easy. You just have to land it at the good range.
Okay.
I mean, good height. It will always connect. If you do it correctly at the good time, always.
Okay.
So it's better to do this with the fireball, but as you can see, it can work with DP, but I really don't understand how it works. So I don't know. And this move also, I didn't talk about this move, the far A, which is good. It covers huge range. So you can stop people from approaching using it, or you can like do this, and if they try to move after, you can stop their movement right. And this move, it's not that great, but the frame data tells that he has invulnerability on some frame, so maybe there's use of those invulnerability frames, but I don't really know the use of it, so I don't talk about it most of the time.
Okay.
But maybe against some guard cancel, you can make them whiff by using this move instead of this one or this. But I don't know. I won't lie. I think Tamura should be able to answer this question, but I can't. I don't really understand the use of this move. So. I don't talk about it most of the time. It's okay. Not that great if you don't know the property of it. And most of the time when I use it, I get it's useless, so I don't know. Maybe there's some use against some card cancel as I speak. I can tell.
Okay, nice. So we talked a bit about training routines, but we can say that all you showed us we can just try in the training.
I would say the first thing to do is quite easy. You put the character on block and you try to DP break.
Okay.
That's it. You go forward and you DP break on the opponent. And once you get the timing, as you can see, you won't miss that effect. And that's the important part, doing the DP break, and you have to know how to do it in both sets, and also the hard combo, at first it can be hard, it's doing it from a low kick, because if you go too fast, sometimes this will happen. It's hard to do. This will happen.
Ah, okay.
So it's good to know how to do it from a low position, I would say. Because the most basic combo you will learn is this one. 2D into 2B, which is a low, into DP, into fireball. So if you're comfortable with this combo, you can play Marco. If you can do this, I would say 90% of the time, you're not ready enough, I would say.
Ah, okay. Nice to know this.
That's one. That's all. As I say, Marco is an easy character, so there's too much things to know. How to do breaks in most situations, and when I say most situations, I mean after most of his normal move.
Yeah.
And the second part is the hardest. Learn how to guard cancel in a real match.
Yeah.
But there's no. They found a Lua script recently for recording inputs, so it will be easier for new players to learn. But in my opinion, the best way to learn guard cancel is to do it in real match. Sadly, that's the best option you have. Because most of the time, when you try one situation, you don't take in consideration that your opponent will adapt and he will just change what he does and you will get stuck doing one stuff which yeah. work in one situation. That's not the good way to get better. I think that's not the good way, but maybe for some people it is.
Okay, nice. Now, I wanted to ask you a couple of matchups, a good one, a bad one.
Recently, we did a French matchup chart. I don't know if you see on the chart, this they didn't show. But I would say that Marco has pretty good matchup. Overall, his matchup chart is pretty balanced. For me, he has one really hard matchup, and most of the other matchup are winning matchup or 5-5 matchup, and the hard matchup, as always, Jeannette.
Okay.
The reason is that maybe I didn't tell it, but Marco DP has any invulnerability. So the only way to deal with die will be counter. But since you can't react to the dive, it's random and you can get punished after. So it's not the good option. So the real good option would be to guard cancel the dive kick, which is hard because it's multi. And also, if the Jeannette is good, she can delay every hit to make the guard cancel harder.
Ah, okay.
And it's really hard to deal with Marco. Even though the matchup isn't as hard as, for example, Rogue versus Jeannette, it's still hard to deal with her pressure. And once you're in the corner, you you're forced to guess, and most of the time, you will do this and get baited and die. So it's really hard to deal with Jeannette. Once you're in the corner, it's nearly game over already. So I think for me, the hardest matchup. And I would say that, at really high level, Dong is also a good matchup against Marco.
Okay.
You can. Marco has a hard time to deal with Dong approaches, and Dong can punish mostly every move of Marco when he has his air super.
Yeah.
So you can't really go forward like you went to. And his neutral game is also better than you. So it's not that hard. I will say it's 5.5 for Dong and 4.5 for Marco. But it's still a little hard. Especially if the Dong is really good, it's really hard to be offensive against.
Okay. Okay, okay, I see. Hello, Kat. Welcome, welcome. We have some questions and answers if the chat yes. want to ask something, and if you want to show combos from counters or yes. anything else, we can do a bit of versus. Yep. Remember just to change the time, the match, the rounds, and then we will change. The handicap.
That's it. I don't remember which way the handicap works. Should I go left or right?
Push dude.
There, I should wait.
Like okay. this.
And maybe I don't know which one, but just not Terry. Oops. Okay. It's not Terry's one. So you will just do jump attack or hop attack into this wall. After this, I can do fireball. And just wait a little, I need bunker. Yes, that's good. As you can see, I didn't tell, but as you can see, you activate the counter, but it didn't hit. It happens sometimes if you press your button really low on the ground, you can avoid the counter even though it activates, but it's hard. You can also go for Super C if you land the counter. And you can also go for DP. In some situations, it will hold the counter with counter state, and you can go for DP break into Super, for example. There, I will talk about an option select because it's not hard and it's really useful. So I will put you down and then you will try to jump or backdash. Okay?
Okay.
Reversal jump or reversal backdash. So there, he will try to jump, but if he jumps,
oh, nice.
There, my DP hit and I can follow with super, and it will also work against backdash. And this round option two. Select. Easy. You need to learn the break timing on it. In Garou, when you break a move, you have three different timings. On it, on block, and on whiff.
Okay.
And with for this option select, you want to use the timing on block every time. So if I do this... I did it too soon. I did it too soon again. The backdash didn't land. But as you can see, I can get your backdash.
Okay.
But. And this time, stay on block. And as you can see, if you are blocking, I will break my DP. And okay. if you're not, then jump again.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
It will not break. So for this option select, the only thing you have to do is to do 2D into DP break with the hit on hit timing. That's it. And it will do so on unblock you will break your DP so you're safe. If the opponent jump, you will not break your DP and you will punish with the DP and then the super.
Yeah.
And if the opponent backdash, you can go for the full combo. This one, which is great. That's okay. An option select pretty basic. And you should know it because in the corner, it's really helpful against many stuff. There's one thing that, two things that beat it. People can warp cancel the 2B and you will lose, which is not that easy to do.
Yeah.
And also, people can air delay GD, which if you try to in Garou, maybe you don't know, but there's something called instant air GD, which is jumping while doing backward instantly. So if someone press a button, you will get a GD. Not that hard to do, but most people don't know that. And this DP will beat instant air GD, but if you delay the GD, you can GD it. So there's option to beat it, but they're so uncommon that most people won't do it anyway. Except at higher level where people have a really, really good defense.
Okay.
So that's the most common option select when to use with Marco. Also, try to backdash. If I win the backdash, I can go for a super A or C or just a fireball to push it.
Yeah.
But I need to read it. So let's say you don't want to backdash and I do it.
Yeah.
I'm in a pretty bad situation. So you really need to have a good
read.
Yes. Exactly.
Yeah.
But that's most of Marco stuff. As I say, it's really based on how good you are to read your opponent. If you can read your opponent really well, Marco is probably one of the best characters.
Okay.
Because he has good damage and he can open you really easily. But if you're not good with guard canceling and you're not really good with reading your opponent, maybe you should try another character because that's not the way you should play it, I think.
Okay.
I think. I saw some Marco trying to be super defensive, but I don't see the point of playing Marco defensive when half of the cast do it way better than him. So, okay. For me, Marco is the second or maybe third best offensive character. The first is Jeannette. Mm-hmm. For me, the second one, the Marco, but we can argue that Kevin the more offensive than Marco. So
okay, I see.
So I would recommend this character for people who want to go on the offensive and we don't want to spend hours and hours in training. Easy and you go forward. That's all you need to do.
Okay, nice. So we saw even the counters. So we can do our usual first to five if you want to.
Yes. Okay.
And
maybe go back in arcade mode.
Yeah, we go back on the normal mode. Let me just change.
Yes. I close it.
Tip switches. Wait. Second. I really like Marco. I like this character.
To be honest with you, I play fighting games for a really long time and I always love Shoto. And I think he is my favorite Shoto to play in every game. I think that if you give Marco's Fireball to any Shoto, the character will get way better than he. Like, imagine having Ryu with Marcos Fireball. It will be so good. So good. But he don't. He doesn't.
Okay, Marco. Let's see. So this week I will be practicing with Marco. I already practiced with Rock.
Yes.
And he's pretty
it's hard. The thing is that I don't want to tell with people, and I should, but with Rock, if you're not good at the game, you won't do anything. That's the sad part about it. You need to be really good to at Garou and with overall mechanics of the game. Because Rock, lui, is bad. And if you don't play really well, you can do anything with this character. Marco, it's not the same. Marco, if you can do this, you won a match. And everyone can do this. It's really easy to play and to understand your winning condition, I think.
Yeah.
And the winning condition is to land a DP move on. That's it.
Yeah, I see. The damage of this character is crazy. Yeah.
It's insane. But if you, as I said, with Marco, the only hard part is to be able to guard cancel most of the stuff people do. But once you can do this, you don't want to deal with Marco.
Wow. Every time you fly, you get a super.
Yes. It's a really stupid character. Really, really stupid character. I think that, in my opinion, you use Tatsumaki, this move too much in neutral. You should only use it in control. I think. Maybe in some situation you can.
Ah, yeah.
But
sometimes
if you could.
I try to do stuff like I was playing Dong.
Yes, but it's not the best way to play Marco, I would say. And there, if I do this, I miss what I want.
Oh.
No. That's why move is bad. Because it's easy to dodge, and if you miss it, you stay not moving for like 2 seconds nearly.
Yeah. Bad.
Round one. I think Marco is a good character to get better in the game, especially with guard cancel. I think. If you can guard cancel with Marco, I think you can guard cancel with most of the character in the game. And you will need to guard cancel with him. So you will get better at it playing with him. Yes, when you know when you don't see your health anymore, you can GT. Round two. Fight. Oh, a little slow. Mm.
yet.
It's hard. Oh, once you see the red dot from the quad crush, hard to deal with pressure. And maybe I didn't tell it, but Marco is a really good guard crusher, in fact. Not, I mean, the level 3 super is really good to do it, but even with Marco this super, is really good to guard crush. Versus Marco Rodriguez.
Round 1. Fight!
Nice. Ah. It's because you get a counter. It's a little unlucky.
Oh my god.
Yes. You don't want to take your cross up from Marco.
Yeah.
Don't.
Yeah, that DP rate, the AD between AP is really, really safe.
Yeah, can do. As I say, I'm minus 2. So. Oh, I missed my super. Please. The only way to punish it is if you JD the C version, it's unsafe. But you need to JD it and react with a super rate, or it's safe.
Oh. You missed the break.
Yes. That's the hard part about Marco. The break is hard and the guard cancel is hard, but every other aspect is easy. So it's quite easy to get good with him. Fast, I would say. Yes. You don't. That's the hard part when you start against Marco. You don't know when you can press a button.
Yeah, and the mix-ups from up and down, it's really hard to read.
I wasn't blocked, but I just made something dead.
Oh my god.
I think it's this. Oh, I miss it. Okay. And you couldn't have punished it, but. This one is quite safe. But yes, Marco is a character and. I play it for years. I know to play against.
Yeah. Nice anyway, nice. I try out Marco for the week. And next week there will be Kota once again with Otaru next week.
Oh, yes. Kota is a good Otaru.
Yeah. And okay, so I guess that for this episode of the Italian Dojo is we talked about everything and
I would say I didn't say that you can combo your DP after every up also, but you can.
Oh, okay.
That's something I forget to say, but it works on every up.
Ah, okay.
That's all you have to do. I think that's the only thing I didn't say.
Okay, nice.
But so... I know that Kota went to show it box to people and complicated stuff.
Yeah.
But I'm not sure it's really useful. But if you want me to, next time I think I will.
Yeah, it can be interesting, especially I think that it is quite useful for neutrals. or some neutrals, because maybe sometimes when I saw some hitboxes from Dong, this yes. Way before the Italian Dojo, so before no, yes. last week's episode, I mm-hmm. discovered how to effectively use neutral. So it could be interesting on some the most used, at least the most used neutrals, for example.
Yeah, okay, but then for the next one, I will show.
Yeah,
I will show box, but from my point of view.
Yeah.
It can. How can I say this? Maybe a little too much for a starting player, I would say. Even though most people who are here play the game for a little time, yeah. I believe. But yeah. Showing its box and stuff, it's maybe a little too much for yeah. a newer player. I don't know. So if you want me to, I can show box next time. There's no problem with it.
Probably, I think that for the most used neutrals, it can be interesting. Just maybe a couple of neutrals, or maybe yes, two from the ground and one or two from the air. The most used, not everything.
I
think that you mean that too many information tend to confuse people, and I agree with that.
Yes, I mean. I say pretty basic stuff. I don't want to go.
Yeah.
I mean, I can explain some really advanced stuff, but I'm pretty sure most people won't get it. So
yeah.
I stay with the really basic
stuff. Absolutely.
But maybe I should go a little more than I. So next time I'll add some hitboxes.
Yeah.
The useful one.
Okay. We can do that. Yeah. Okay, so Koro, thank you for helping us out with Marco.
Yeah, and no problem. Thanks you to.
We will see you again on the next episodes. And what else? Thank you for the viewers to being with us. And so we will see again probably next Sunday. Always at the same time, but with Kota showing us Otaru. So that being said, have a good night, everyone, and see you next time.
Good night, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye.